What's up, Sim Racers? This is Larry at TJRSim here, and I want to cover Forza Motorsports some settings, some graphical settings, and some force feedback settings. Now, I'm using an AccuForce V2 direct drive wheel. I think it's peak at 16 newton meters of torque, and so it's pretty powerful. I love this wheel. I've been using it forever, in just one day, and previous Forza Motorsports, the force feedback, the tire modeling and all that has been horrendous and really hard to get to work correctly with a direct drive wheel. I found that it works perfectly for, but really good, very usable for sim wheels that are like maybe a Logitech G29 or lower end wheels where it doesn't need to pick up everything and it works just fine, right? It gives you a fairly good gameplay. But anyway, I want to cover some settings here. First, let's just knock out the video settings here. Now, as you saw there on this previous one, it looks beautiful. The game looks beautiful. However, you do get some hiccups here in the system when you're actually in gameplay, when it's rolling through some animations, maybe like your guys jumping out on track and trying to go to the car and the pits and stuff, which I love, by the way, but I got some hiccups. Now, I'm using a GPU, an older GPU, a 2080 Ti, if y'all remember those. And so I got an i7, I forget the CPU actually that I have, but I got a new rig coming here with a 4090, so I'll be able to compare it with what settings I have now with this 2080 Ti, so it's a good time to do it right now, and then give you some settings for when I get the 4090 again. So, but what I did to get this to work a lot better for me is basic video. I don't run benchmarks, but dynamic rendering, take screenshots if you need to, is medium. Optimization, it just defaults to custom automatically. I'm running 2560 by 1440 screen, and I like to show the frame rate. Now, with these settings, I am getting anywhere from 75 to 87, it's really hard to see because it fluctuates back and forth up here at the top of the screen, FPS with these settings. So it's really good, it's very smooth, and it seems fast to your eye, right? So that's really what I'm wanting. So NVIDIA DLSS, love that. I have RTX cards so I can turn this on, so I set that to quality. All right, so we'll go to advanced video here. Go on down the list, take a screenshot of here. Dynamic render quality, medium. This is what's worked great for me. I turned off the performance target. You can lock it at 60, it'll stay there all day long if you're comfortable with 60. However, I just wanted to see how much FPS I could actually get. So I didn't mind it fluctuating and showing me. Resolution scale auto, atmospheric filtering auto. That actually seems to work pretty good. Ray tracing off, that's a killer. RTO quality on low. Which is your ray tracing quality, which once you turn it off, that doesn't really matter, but just in case, I set it on low. Shadow quality on medium, and these settings here as far as graphics goes, looks really, really good. I'll show you some gameplay footage later on. So, all right, now, let's get into the settings. Now, first of all, if you are doing your input settings here, unfortunately, it doesn't know all the wheels. You know, it has a lot of them on there, actually. It has a Fanatic, even has Moza on there, but it doesn't have my wheel, which is AccuForce. So, you want to go to Custom Input 1, and copy a blank layout, right, and then assign your setting. So, if you are using AccuForce, this is how you're going to have to do it. One glitch I see here is when you're here, you can't go over here and rename it. It just doesn't let you rename, so that's a pity. So maybe that'll change in the future. But moving on quickly, when you go to advanced input here, now this is pretty self-explanatory. Steering left and right, dead zone, 0, 100, steering right, axis inverse off, enforce force readback, force feedback is on. Your acceleration dead zone in and out like that, 0 and 100, acceleration invert off, deceleration 0 and 100, deceleration off, clutch. I put that at 5 just because sometimes I rest my foot on the clutch, although my clutch is set super stiff, so it probably wouldn't matter, but I keep it at 5. Same thing with a handbrake, just in case I didn't have my Husenfeld handbrake adjusted quite properly. I'll keep it on 5, because in previous Forza games, when I kept this at 0, it would register as if I'm applying the brake. So I keep it a little safe, keep it on 5. There's no registry pickup, right? So that's my suggestion. Okay, here, vibration scale, and we'll get into the actually settings here. Vibration scale, set this to your heart's content. I got a powerful wheel, so 50 is pretty good. This is just the vibration intensity that you get to the wheel, right? Force feedback scale, that's on 80. I put it on 80. Now, I run on my AccuForce, I run default, 900 degrees of rotation. If you know anything about AccuForce, the default setting gives you the most more true, not hyper responsive, but more of a true feedback through your wheel. So, more bumps, feel like bumps, etc. Self alignment, leave it on 100. Mechanical trail, this is your big ones, mechanical trail and pneumatic trail. So, let's see, mechanical trail, I'm setting it on 150. I like this setting, it seems to work really good. I can feel when the tires are trying to self-align really good with this, even though that doesn't necessarily do just that part of it. But it says here it scales the length of the static lever arm from suspension geometry, raising this tenth to give a smoother force but less fidelity. So you get a little bit more smoother force on the high end, but you don't quite feel it as much. But 100 wasn't quite there. It wasn't giving me the pull around effect that I wanted. The feel of self straightening and the mechanical feel of the car turning, right? Just didn't give it to me. So 150 worked really good for me, and it seems to work on all the cars, anywhere from the higher end GT cars to the road cars, right? Now, pneumatic scale, trail scale. This is your rubber to the road. You know, how does your tires feel? Like when you go over the big sausages on the side of the track here, and you have that deformation in the tire, the rubber itself. You like in the videos they show for Forza, you see it. The guys bump up over these curving, right, and the car bounces up in the air. I want to feel that pneumatic. I want to feel that decompression of the tire and then rebound of the tire, right? So. This one being too high is horrible. You can't feel anything. You can't feel when a tire's pushing or anything. So 40 is where I like it. I can go as low as 30. But what this does is it says length of dynamic lever arm from the moving tire contact patch. Scaling this down will reduce the dynamic effects from tire deformation. So in other words, if you go too low, you won't get that feeling of when the tire's skipping or sliding across the track. But if you go too high, it'll feel like when you get to the edge of the tire, your steering wheel will just go away, right? It'll just go super light really fast, right? And then what happens is you get all the road scale feel, the road feel bouncing in, and your vibration starts going crazy, right? And so that's very distracting. You're like, okay, when it vibrates like crazy when I'm in a curve and I lost traction on the front end, I know it's vibrating like crazy, but heck, it vibrates like crazy on the straightaways a lot of times anyway. So I want to eliminate, only want to feel the vibration when I'm actually doing something, right, with the tire, when I'm losing traction and so forth. But I want to have some road feel as well. So, but that's where this pneumatic, mechanical trail and pneumatic trail, these two play a big role in how your car actually feels on track. So for direct drive wheels, probably a DD1, Fanatec DD1, some of the Moses, anything that's 10 Newton meters and up, I would suggest this would be a better setting. But this is very controversial if you want it to be, but some people have a different feel. Some people are using very wide rims, and so you don't get as much feedback to the edge of your rim. I use a cube control rim, so it's a high force feedback wheel, so I feel everything really well, so I have to turn the feedback down. So also keep in mind that your force feedback scale, you know, if you've had this up too high, your wheel's going to feel very stiff to you, and you're not going to feel all the granule inputs that you're getting from here. So it's best to start something low, especially with really any wheel brand, even if you have a low-end G29 or something like that, right? Which it's fine, I love them too, I had one too. But power too much, right? Okay, so road fill scale here. That's at 70. That's how much you want to fill with the curbing. But not only curbing, actually. You can turn this completely down or off, right? You can turn it completely off. You'll still fill curbing. When you go over the curbs, you'll still fill it from the vibration scale. And you'll fill it from the mechanical trill and the pneumatic, right? It'll. This is a scale of what these are doing, the self-alignment and these, right? That's the scale of the vibration you get. Whatever vibration these create from the road surface, this is the scale of that you feel, right? You think maybe 100 would be, 100 would be better, right? But it's not. It's too much. It's just distracting, basically. So, but your road fill adjusted to what you had it. I forgot what I had it at now. 70, something like that. But adjusted to your liking. What I found, especially on higher-end wheels or direct drive wheels that have a higher frequency range, that steps that you feel when you're rotating the wheel. When I have this road fill scaled up too high, I end up feeling, when I'm going straight down the track, I end up feeling not the bumps that you're supposed to feel, but it almost feels like the wheel comes off center and it's hitting like a knock, like a hard flat surface you got to get over. It's very disorienting to feel that going on the road, because I just want to feel a granular feel of the road itself, not this like you're running over big rocks kind of thing, right? So I end up turning it back down a little bit to be happy with what I feel, so it's not distracting me going down the straights, but I have a little bit of vibration of what's going on in the road. Of course, once you start making a turn, like I said, that's where these will pick up, and this will be the scaling of the vibration. So when you're sliding your front end, you'll feel this. You want to feel a lot more vibration, you can turn this up higher, right? But again, you have to play with these settings, and too much is a higher scale, is too much. It masks what's going on here. So, want to keep it fun, and you also want to keep it bringing tilts along with your vehicle on the track. So, wheel damping scale, I leave it off, or 5 rather. Because if off, that means your wheels just turn freely and don't feel any impact. Center spring, don't need any of that. Turn it off. You're already covering it with self steering alignment here. Centering spring is just, it gets confusing with self alignment. This is when you're coming out of a curve and the wheel will self align itself because inertia, right? Rotational mass will be spinning. Inertia will make the wheel want to turn straight as you're straightening up. Center spring is really just the weight on the shoulder wheel, so why mask your little effects with this? See, dynamic damper, same as wheel damper. You make that on, just keep it at 5. And the rest is pretty easy. Steering sensitivity and linearity, that's just default. And you don't need any filters and stuff. So I hope this has been helpful to you. And hopefully this has been helpful. Maybe I'll run through a quick race if you want to stick around and see what the graphics actually look like. Here you can check that out. Maybe this guy. Random auto girls, except all. And I'll actually also do a review, my thoughts on Forza Motorsports, but I just want to get this out to people that are playing Forza right now. Get some good, decent. Really, this game played really well.
Here at Maple Valley, finish the fast Turn 1 farmhouse carousel on the far left to avoid the pit exit road, where cars will be merging onto the track.
Well, sorry about that. The game cut off short here. I had a computer meltdown. Had it locked up. So the reason why I'm getting another PC here with a 4090 and a updated, you know, with the updated graphics card. Sometimes I have some issues where it will lock up my computer when I'm trying to record. And so, yeah, I'm trying to get a better setup here so I can get back into the swing of things here. But I won't dive in and bore you. You saw where the resolution, the resolution, the FPS was 80s, and 90s. That is typically what I see throughout the whole race with 23 cars on there. So anywhere from the 70s to 80s in rain, same with nighttime with those graphic settings. So with that said, I'll just leave it at that, and I hope you enjoyed this quick look at Forza Motorsports, some graphical settings for older video cards like a 2080 Ti, and also good force feedback settings for some direct drive wheels, or higher end wheels rather. So direct drive is a lot more popular nowadays, so expect more people to start jumping into that direction over, say, belt. So hopefully this will be helpful to you.